I'm Anna Nervegna and this is Toby Reed. We're presenting our Central Goldfields Art Gallery, which stands on the Dja Dja Wurrung land, and we pay our respects to elders of all nations, past, present and emerging. So the Central Goldfields has a rich kind of landscape that we all know and love, including the gold rush and the indigenous rock wells. The town itself, as Mark Twain said, is Maryborough itself has a station of the town attached to it because these large gold rush buildings are quite out of scale. This is the building that we worked on, the original fire station from 1861.
And they're at opposite ends of the axis. The town is between these two buildings.
Yeah. And then a later addition, the magnificent tower with timber structure of 1888. So the gallery got us in to provide a ramp access within the space. This was the existing gallery.
It was a rabbit warren inside, which is walls everywhere, you know, like 150 years
of layers.
Of bad renovations.
When looking at this building, we realised that once you're in the building, the access or knowledge of the tower disappeared. Because it was a fire station, obviously, it had a particular relationship with the bell tower, but we felt as a cultural building we could change that. And we developed an idea of exposing and opening the gallery in various kind of axes.
Yeah, and it's really important that at the same time as we got the job of doing the building, Djandak, representing the Dja Dja Wurrung, we're designing the sculpture garden, which is to the north there. And so the two projects, although they're staged in construction, were designed together. And it was very important for us to have a dialogue with Dja Dja Wurrung and to find a way of actually making this Victorian colonial building relate to their landscape.
So this shows all the functions of the program, including back of house and new gallery spaces. So we felt that the gallery building externally was not to be tampered with. We reopened an original fire garage door to the original building as a new entry, and the old entry became an opportunity for a projection space at evening for digital artwork.
And we repainted the doors, super graphics on it, which came from actually up Victorian buildings.
Yeah. When we were designing this, we thought about how we could interconnect and interlace. We had this issue of the colonial history of the building, and we wanted to introduce space for the Indigenous history that we felt needed to be entwined within this structure. Not to privilege one from another, but to open up space for a new dialogue between two very diverse histories.
Yes. So we sort of cut channels through the building. We actually sort of, rather than designing through addition, we really designed through subtraction. So we erased things, we erased walls that were not needed, we created new sort of spatial voids that connected the garden to the interior.
The client was really concerned with opening up the building to the community. It obviously has art patrons, but they wanted to increase their patronage through actually engaging with the street. So we opened up the fire station doors, which were, you know, bolted shut and sealed off.
And walls behind.
So now the openings and the program can spill out onto the street. And the tower we addressed through two skylights, which not only brought in new light to the quite dark interior, but we established a relationship, a vista up to the tower through the skylight. So here's the skylight in the reception and the view looking up to the tower. So once you enter, you become engaged again with the tower.
Yeah, and the low view is through to the Indigenous garden that will be sort of finished at the, probably later in the year.
So we saw this space as form, and we started to think about how, because the budget was so tight, we were resistant to kind of add on things, and we wanted to actually reveal the glory of the colonial architecture, but also open space for a new dialogue which would engage with the Indigenous garden, which we work with in the Wataka with the Dja Dja Wurrung clan. And this became a series of spatial relationships up to the tower, but also through to the garden and across through the permanent collection. So both histories are privileged here. We're trying not to privilege one or the other.
You're really trying to open up space for alternate histories,
yeah.
Alternate stories.
Here are the skylights looking up from the reception to the tower. And the vista across to the permanent collection from the main gallery through the reception, offering new opportunities and spaces. This is the ramped gallery which we created, separate from the main gallery, which has another skylight that is oval that transforms into a square picture frame, which also looks towards the tower.
So all the rooms are at different heights, and so we had to make it all accessible. So we sort of created that ramp gallery in the middle. Rather than just being a ramp, we sort of made it like a pop-up space for young artists.
Yeah, so it's DDA compliant without handrails, so we saw an opportunity to offer another gallery space which we hadn't anticipated.
And you can see there, you get the views, just go back. But up to the tower, if the exposure were right, but you're standing there, and then you get like through to the garden on the left, and then through to the main space on the right.
Yeah,
okay.
This is looking through back into the gallery, the grand garage as gallery space, and across.
Awesome.
The footsteps of the original concrete pour revealed, the proposed Indigenous sculpture garden, which will be here this year, the exterior.
And we created this moon wall on the facing the garden, which lights up from inside. And once it's got trees around it and everything, you feel like a sort of big moon setting sun.
So in the Wataka, we offered that as a gesture that they could engage with in the planning of the landscape. And they were very, we worked on that together.
Yeah.
There is the reception with the original brickwork, which was quite fragile and needed to be preserved.
And we kept all the old floor plan, so you get remnants of where things were. That's the collection.
This is the climate control.
It's time.
Yep.
Okay.
The opening, the education room, which opened a few weeks ago. Thank you.